Today, students can take pictures with their cell phones, handheld video games, even with MP3 players. So why would anyone want to study photography, only to take pictures with outdated cameras, then develop the film using slow, old-fashioned methods?
I feel that if something's more vintage, you want to have it for longer, and I mean, something more important should be held in film. It's tangible, it's not like just a file on a device, because you can lose that.
You're so used to the hustle and bustle of the digital world. It's just kind of cool to take a step back and use film and know that, you know, you can't redo it. You can't just go on there and delete the picture if you mess it up. You know, you have to deal with it.
These students are enrolled in Photography 1 class here at Westfield High School. Teacher Kim Basinger, no relation to the actress, says her classes are about the art of photography, which means her students must first learn how to slow down.
My own students are so used to, quick, I got an answer, you know. Do we even have time to go to the dictionary and look up a definition? No, you know, you're typing a Word document and you right click and there it is, right there, there's the answer. It's wonderful in many ways, but at the same time, people expect for something to happen that quickly. And they don't pause and think about the enormity of the whole experience. It is very cool. And so as you do this, as you're shooting this photo, you're not gonna see the person creating these long lines. It's not until you develop the film that you're gonna see this. So you have to be patient and wait. It makes you slow down, it makes you relax. The whole process itself in terms of developing the film. And of course, the dark room, it's like, it's just cool. You go in there and it's dark and the light is red and just magical to see the images come up.
At Westfield, four levels of year-long photography class are offered, which is uncommon in FCPS. To facilitate the increased number of classes, staff made space for a second dark room. So here, the use of film isn't fading away anytime soon.
The idea is that students are using not just photography as in the technical side, but also trying to think conceptually as an artist. And so we try to integrate that in our classes. And so Fairfax County decided, hey, you know, they're at this point where should we still do film or should we just go to digital? And they decided that, yes, let's stick with the film-based class. And I'm totally in favor of that.
Here in Photo 3 class, students paint over top of their photos, allowing students to experiment with complementary colors and light and shadow. Like in any art class, photography students develop strong planning, cooperation, and problem-solving skills.
Planning, I definitely have to think a lot more about what I'm gonna shoot, and like, I can't just go out there and just look at a tree and shoot it and decide I don't like it. So I do have to plan a lot more and actually think about what I am gonna shoot and put a lot of thought into it.
I think you have to put a lot of time into what you're doing. You have to really think about it and make sure that you've put a lot of effort and time into what you're doing. And I think it helps with all different classes. You need to know those skills to be able to do stuff in your life.
And so when they're taking a test, a standardized test like the SATs or the SOLs, they actually can creatively think. They can problem solve. And it works its way all the way through everything. It's not just in the dark room or in the classroom. It's how can you apply this to anything?
You have to plan every step out in what you're gonna do. And I think that helps me in other classes. You know, I'm more diligent in writing down my assignments and thinking ahead to the future and trying to figure out how I'm gonna spend time on every assignment and get it done.
Helping build 21st century skills, photography class is offering a refreshing place for students to slow down and reveal more than just photos.
I think that that's a great word because I think that says it all. It's the reveal, and it could be the reveal in the dark room, the reveal of the image coming up. It's the reveal of the students', you know, inner thoughts coming out. I feel like that's it. I think it's the reveal because you're forced to slow down and to reveal it all. And that's awesome.